What's going on, gamers? Today, we are going to go over how to set admins on a 7 Days to Die server. Before we get started, don't forget to like, subscribe, and click that notification bell to stay up to date on all future videos. In the dangerous world of 7 Days to Die, there are a lot of situations where you'll wish that you had admin commands to use. When a player is set as an admin, they get access to a variety of server commands. This can be helpful for moderating the server and removing troublesome players, or for even changing the world itself. And whether you ban players, adjust the weather, spawn creatures, or more, this can all be done as long as you have the access. This is easy to do in your server panel, so let's get started. Head into the steamid.io website, and then using the text field, search for the Steam user that you want to admin. Once they're found, find the Steam ID64 section and then copy the full text. First, make sure the player has connected to your 7 Days to Die server. Next, head into your Apex server panel and log in, and in the left-hand menu, find and select the console option. On the next page, enter the following command into the text field, replacing the Steam ID with the ID of your player. Submit the command to set the player as an admin. Once admin access is granted, the in-game console can be used by pressing the F1 key. This will open up a large menu on the top of the screen, allowing commands to be entered in the lower section. You can enter a command, and then you can press enter to submit the command. If it's successful, then you should get a message in the console. There are a ton of different commands that you can use, which you can find on the 7 Days to Die wiki page. But if you're looking for some of the most important ones, here are some of the ones that we find might be most beneficial. That is how you set admins in your 7 Days to Die server, and how to use the commands. Whether you use these to use the cheat commands, or you use the commands just to moderate, having this power is extremely helpful as a server owner. But because being an admin gives you so much power, remember to only give access to the players that you really trust. And if you ever feel like you need to remove somebody's access, you can do that by typing in this command in the console tab using the player's username. That's all for this one, gamers. As always, I hope you have lots of fun.
Thanks for watching. If you want to see more great content like this, then subscribe or click these videos. Until next time, gamers.